As the sun rises over the 6,100-kilometer long coast of India, farmers and fisherfolk have, for centuries, awakened to a day of hope. Abundant land and water, ensuring prosperity. The promise of work, rewarded by a plentiful catch. A rich harvest to be reaped for all times to come. Over the centuries, the coastal communities have evolved a harmonious relationship with nature. A relationship founded upon respect rather than on greed. Today, a grey cloud looms over the Indian coast. Intensive shrimp farming, merely 3 years old, threatens the 2,000-year-old coastal culture. The Blue Revolution, which has not lasted more than a few years in Taiwan, in Thailand, and in Indonesia, is now being aggressively promoted in India. And the people have spontaneously resisted this destruction of their culture and their livelihood. The threat posed by the export-oriented shrimp culture forced the octogenarian Gandhian leader, Sri Jagannathan, and his wife, Krishnamal, to call for a satyagraha, or a non-violent direct action, to stop further destruction.
This big village of Perundotam are 2,200 acres total, but five companies, prawn companies, have invaded this village, and occupied nearly 1,000 acres. Nearly 50% of the land now under the prawn companies. What will happen to this village, Perundotam? It will perish. Perundotam is in peril because of these prawn companies. And now Satyagraha is going on. This is the Perundotam is the Satyagraha camp for me, for myself and the movement.
Are you there?
aquaculture destroys the land, the water, the forests, and the biodiversity of the coastal ecosystem. The mangrove forest, which are eons old, are the breeding places for over 60% of the fish caught for trade, including shrimp, and are being illegally destroyed to make place for shrimp farms.
Bhitarkanika is such a beautiful sanctuary, which is the, I will say, nature's gift to humanity. It is the duty of everybody to preserve it. But astonishingly, 10 prawn ponds companies have already invaded. The entire Bhitarkanika will be completely spoiled.
Land, the survival base of the agricultural community. The coastal belt is known as the rice bowl of India, rich in diverse varieties of paddy and millet, feeding millions of farming and fishing families. For many farmers, an acre of land means the difference between life and death. Today, the shrimp industry is taking over this fertile land, often by having it declared a wasteland.
Was this agricultural land or was it wasteland?
Well, the majority of the land is wasteland, which is not being used for any other purposes.
Did you buy it directly from the people who owned it or from the government?
We bought it directly from the people who owned it.
Out of this 54,000 hectares which has been converted in Andhra Pradesh, little over 22,000 hectares, 22,630 hectares of agricultural land has been converted, which means in terms of food grains lost, paddy, how much it's lost, the groundnut, how much it's lost, the ragi, the millets, the kind of tonnage that's lost. It's enormous. About 1.3 lakh tons of rice has been lost in this kind of land. Groundnut, a little over 13,000 tons of groundnut has been lost. Millets also, several thousands of tons have been lost. The basic food security in the area is at stake.
Prawn culture, those who say, is on wasteland on the coast, absolutely are liars. They are trying to deceive the Indian people. I can give you proof now that all those prawn companies who have applied to the pollution control board of the state only recently, because of my pressure, all in their forms have filled up that it is agricultural land.
And what happens if the people refuse to sell?
நாங்க வந்துங்க எந்த ஒரு விதமான ஒரு குற்றமும் நாங்க செய்யலைங்க. எங்களுக்கு வந்து நிலங்கள் எல்லாம் குறைச்சலா இருக்குன்னு சொல்லிட்டு ராலு பண்ணக்காரங்க வந்து ராலு பண்ண வந்து இங்க போடுறதுக்காக வந்து அனுமதி கேட்டாங்க. நாங்க தர முடியாது சொல்லிட்டோங்க. எங்களுக்கு கொஞ்ச நிலமா இருக்கு, அதனால நாங்க அதுல தான் நாங்க பாடுபட்டு திங்கணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு நாங்க கொடுக்க மாட்டோம்னு சொல்லிட்டோம். மக்கா நாள் என்ன செய்யுது, ஆட்டோவுல வந்து அவங்க படைக்க வந்தாங்க. நாங்க அடையாளம் வந்து விரட்டினதாக நாங்க ராலு பண்ண மறையலுக்காக தான் நாங்க பெண்கள் எல்லாம் போனோம். ஆண்கள் எல்லாம் வந்து பொய் வழக்கு போட்டு எல்லாரையும் அங்க செயலுக்கு பிடிச்சிட்டு போயிட்டாங்க. இந்த ரால் பண்ணக்காரனும் போலீஸை வச்சு அங்கே வீட்டெலாம் தீ வச்சுட்டாங்க.
Coastal belt of India has always had abundant water for fishing, for farming, and for use in homes. The depletion and pollution of water resources has led to a sharp decline in fish availability, snatching away the livelihood of people. In 3 short years, the Puttappu Rajas, kings of the coast as the fishermen call themselves, are left with no resources, no livelihood, no future.
ஊரு எப்படி போயிட்டிருந்தோ அப்படியே நினச்சி ஏமே இல்லாக்கொண்டா சமுதாய காசுக்கணும். மகாத்தால சமுதாய காடா ஏதோ ஏட்டுக்கு போய் ஏதோ பாலா டபுள் தச்சுக்கொண்டுனார். பாலா டபுள் தச்சுக்கொண்ட டைமில் ஈரோஜு 3 சம்வத்சரம் நினச்சி ஆ சமுதிர தேவி கடை பாட்டு வந்தக்கு போய்
ஈ விஷ
தேன வாழ்ந்த ரொயில் குண்டால வச்சு చుట్టూ గుంటలేసి కట్టలు వేసేసి అది ఒక పట్టణంగా పెట్టేసి అది ఒక కరెంటులో పెట్టేసి ఆ చేపలు కూడా బయటికి రాకుండా లోపలే పోతుంది. ఆ బయటకు వచ్చింది లేదు, ఇది తెచ్చుకున్నది లేదు, ఇది తినేది లేదు.
ఇట్ ఈస్ అ బ్రూటల్ ప్రాసెస్ బై విచ్ ద ప్రోటీన్ ఇస్ ఎక్స్ట్రాక్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద పూర్ పీపుల్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఫ్రమ్ ద ల్యాండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్డ్ బై ద పూర్ పీపుల్. అండ్ దిస్ ఎక్స్ట్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ప్రోటీన్ to feed the already, you know, bloated people, bloated stomach of the rich countries, this is certainly a violation of the right to life.
10,000 12,000 lok mane sitiki jaithilu bondo bhangiya paingi amadi sitte au jaga delami tata wala thana delami chaliya paingi sabu ame hatasa hoi galu ame pila man ko sub badiya pita kori మరి నా నౌర నై జాల కాదు తక్కు నై.
కానీ ఆ గవర్నమెంట్ ఇంతవరకు వీళ్ళు రొయ్యలు గుంటాలు చెరువు గుంటాలు చేసిన దానికి గవర్నమెంట్ కూడా మనకి మనలో కూడా కొనేసినట్టు ఉండాలి అని అనుకుని మేము చాలా బాధలు పడిపోతున్నాం.
నెల్లూర్, నేమ్డ్ ఆఫ్టర్ నెల్లు ఓ ప్యాడీ, ఎ ల్యాండ్ వన్స్ రిచ్ ఇన్ వాటర్ రిసోర్సెస్, is now a saline desert. Even as millions of liters of seawater are being pumped into aquaculture ponds, the local people are in the throes of a water famine, as wells and drinking water sources have turned saline.
Aquaculture incidentally is being undertaken in the remotest of places where even drinking water is not available. So as a result of these aquaculture farms which are coming up in those areas, the drinking water which is being brought by tankers is also distributed amongst the farmer families, and they also benefit from this.
Whatever they get in terms of tankers, through tankers, by the grace of the so-called industrialists, if they come, then there is literally a quarrel. It's a quarrel between the young and the old. It's a quarrel between the mother as well as the daughter-in-laws. So it has created a social tension within the village with reference to water distribution itself. Who is going to get the water first? And this shortage of water within this village has created not just tensions but divisions. This cohesive community, the fisher folk community, for all these centuries, they never lived in this kind of a situation where they have to fight for a glass of water.
The once fertile fields have also become saline, making them unfit for growing anything, including fodder.
Intensive shrimp farming, done in the style in which it's being promoted in country after country in Asia, instantly pollutes groundwater, turns it saline, pumps huge amounts of seawater into the tanks, which disturbs the marine life on the coastal zone,